Sweet Orr's journey began with an Irishman, James Orr, or Uncle Jim, panning for gold during the California Gold Rush. According to a publication circulated a number of years later, it was rumored that while bending over, Uncle Jim heard an almighty rip from his trousers. It was then that he wondered, where can I get pre-made workwear? The answer? Nowhere. After an unsuccessful venture on the dusty gold fields, Orr returned to Wappingers Falls, New York in 1871 with no gold in his pockets and down on his luck. What he did have was a new vision, to make protective workwear. Being a persuasive salesman, Orr convinced his nephews Clayton and Clinton Sweet to buy into his dream. Uncle Jim and his nephew set up shop and began developing the first set of Sweet Orr garments in July of the same year. Checking, measuring, double-checking, and measuring again was the order of the day. After all, quality was the underlying promise that would set Sweet Orr apart. Sweet Orr's salespeople had to find innovative ways to showcase the quality of their garments. And so a test was invented, the tug of war. The guarantee was simple. Six men would not be able to pull the garment apart. And if they did, everyone at the event would get a free pair of trousers. The iconic image of the test stuck and has since been immortalized as the trademark for 150 years. With this innovative spirit flowing through the sales team, it was time for them to set sail across the seas. Before setting sail across the Atlantic Ocean, Sweet Orr had to establish new friendships, namely with the Liverpudlians at Libro Limited, who are still their partners on the company's letterhead to this day in South Africa. This established British workwear company accepted the high-quality unsewn garments from the Americans at Sweet Orr and would put them together on their side of the pond. These items were eventually shipped across the globe, creating a workwear empire, one that would span 36 countries. In 1931, Sweet Orr opened the doors of its South African factory in Woodstock, Cape Town. In 1969, needing more space, Sweet Orr relocated the factory to its current location in Elsie's River. Ever since the first day in 1871, Wappingers Falls, New York, women have been the muscle behind Sweet Orr's success. The same is true to this day, as women are still the driving force behind their legacy of quality workwear. Sweet Orr quickly became the go-to supplier for a number of iconic institutions, like the U.S. Armed Forces and the Boy Scouts of America, for more than 100 years. According to the New York Times, Sweet Orr was arguably the first commercial producer of the blue jean. But it is the Ace of Spades range that is nowadays a global vintage icon, timeless, classic Americana. Today, Sweet Orr's hard-wearing workwear is still being shipped across continents, taking care of the personal protective requirements of hard-working individuals across industries. After 150 years in operation, Sweet Orr's legacy is one to be proud of. The brand has constantly strived to produce workwear that is truly timeless. While their journey began all the way back in 1871, there's no end in sight. This is just the beginning.